and Taylor Dahl.
This is Helmets and Heels
on 1010 XL, switched on by First Coast Lighting and Fans. Upscale lighting, fans, and home decor. Show me what you got, pretty lady.
Welcome into a Friday edition of Helmets and Heels. It is our first Friday edition. Yeah. I suppose every day this week has been a first.
Yes.
And like it's been back. A blast. Yes, we're back.
I'm not That's saying, right. but I'm saying, did we start the earthquake? many are asking, especially those nooners up in the tri-state area. Hope everybody's okay. I hope your lawn chair knocking over didn't knock something else over. And yeah, I hope you can find your hurricane insurance to pay for
that. Just joking about it's the Yankees home opener and there happens to be earthquakes and
we thought
some crazy stuff.
A 4-0 start, Taylor, 5-0 start, whatever it was. Like we were like, yes, good, yes. good omen, and now we have an earthquake.
You're like, oh no.
It's over. maybe it's for the basketball front though, because we also completely ignored, and again, with all the jest and joking, I hope everyone is okay
yes.
if you're listening from New York, New Jersey, Connecticut, Maryland, where everybody was affected by this 4.8 magnitude earthquake. We kind of buried the lead when we were speaking with Foye Aluikin yesterday, which our thanks again to the Jaguars linebacker for joining us live in studio yesterday with our discussion of college basketball, his picks. I was talking with him on the way out, as well as Graham Marsh. We completely forgot to address the fact that UConn, the reigning national champions, mm-hmm. could not get a plane to Phoenix.
Oh, I know, and I saw that article on right before, and I forgot to say something.
For a flight... For a game, excuse me, that will be played tomorrow night. And granted, Phoenix or Pacific time, because I know they don't acknowledge daylight savings out there. I don't even know what time zone they're in. I know they don't do daylight savings. But there was a chance, ladies, that UConn wasn't going to get on a plane until early this morning. Thankfully, an Allegiant chartered plane appeared out of nowhere from somewhere in Cincinnati at 1 a.m. Eastern yesterday morning, got them to Phoenix at 6 a.m. Eastern. But that coupled with the earthquake has me a little suspicious about UConn repeating.
Oh my goodness. I can understand that. As most people know, I don't love to fly. So anytime
yes.
I see mechanical failure, my stomach literally goes in knots. So I feel for them. But I am certainly glad that things will go off according to plan. We will talk basketball certainly in this show today. But we want to start with your Jacksonville Jaguars. Really interesting Jaguars Today show today. Preceding us with some people that don't believe in Trevor Lawrence. And mm-hmm. I find that fascinating because of all the yes, he's had ups and downs, but most quarterbacks do. And now everyone wants to compare young quarterbacks to CJ Stroud, who had an unbelievable year, and he did it with people, with receivers, tight ends that people wouldn't say are top 10 fantasy players or top 10 at their position. But not every player is the same, and we'll see if CJ Stroud can repeat it. But focusing just on Trevor Lawrence, I saw an article the other day, and it was rating all the quarterbacks, and it had different adjectives for each one. So by Trevor Lawrence, Jaguars quarterback, it had solid. So mm-hmm. Taylor, I ask you, what would be your adjective to describe Trevor Lawrence?
I think that's fitting, personally. I think that there's obviously been ups and downs. I think the start was rocky, which affected things. Then injuries affected things. But I think there's obviously, when you have the most turnovers in the last two seasons of any quarterback, that's something that you have to address. We've talked about the situational football, but you've also seen moments from Trevor where you know everything else is there. You know it can all be there. I just feel like we haven't seen, not last year, but the year before, it was a lot of games where the Jags were coming back, and we were seeing Trevor in those moments where we were like, okay, like he's able to kind of take the reins when it's late in a game and figure things out. And we had all these crazy comebacks in the end, and that's what led, including the Chargers game in the playoffs, obviously. And then last year it was almost opposite, to where they were coming out hot, scoring pretty quickly, but then things would kind of die off the middle of the game, and then they'd find a way to win at the end. And this is early, obviously towards the end they couldn't figure out how to win. But so there's been ups and downs, and it's almost like the moment you think one side of things is being fixed, the other side, other things start to fall apart. So you're waiting for everything to kind of fully fall into place. And I think we're still in that moment, but there's no part of me that looks at this and is like, we haven't seen solid, good, potentially elite play out of Trevor Lawrence. You just haven't seen it consistently.
Yeah, I was going to say, I'm going to boil all of yours down to, I'm going to give you an adjective of inconsistent.
Mm-hmm.
Would that work for Trevor?
Yeah.
Okay, so hers is inconsistent. What about you, Mia?
I wouldn't even go so far as inconsistent. I think there's one clear flaw in the game, and it's ball mm-hmm. security. I think there's a reason it's why Doug Peterson has harped on it so much since the season ended and in the final month of the season as well, which obviously he was battling injuries at the time. To a caller on Jaguars Today's point of Trevor never negatively affects his teammates. If you look at the success that Christian Kirk has had, the elevation of Zay Jones and the perception of him, Evan Engram having back-to-back career years, I think that's true. I think this idea of can he elevate the play of his receivers has been proven. Now, granted, there already was some raw talent to begin with, and there was promise. Christian Kirk was a number two wide receiver in Arizona. He got paid mightily, and it was an opportunity for him to become a number one wide receiver. Trevor helped take him there, though. I think you can't dismiss that point.
By the way, I think Kirk is getting married this week.
He is. I was. Yeah. You stole my thunder. Yeah. Round of applause, RJ. Yes, a round of applause for the Kirks as they are getting married, I believe, out in Arizona. In their native Arizona.
There's like multiple weddings coming up, right?
Yeah, Evan Ingram's getting married next weekend, and then they literally start OTAs that Monday, which I said to him, I was like, good luck with hopefully there's not another earthquake, and your flight back is okay, because you literally got to be at work Monday morning at 8 a.m.
Right.
After getting married on Saturday, but I digress.
Yeah, sorry, I interrupted.
No, you're good. The point I was about to make is that he does negatively affect his teammates with ball security, because that's the most important thing, as Doug Peterson continues to reiterate.
Lack thereof, yeah.
Correct. And it's an essential part of the football game, of the game of football, I should say. But if you take that out of it, tell me where he negatively affects his team. Sure, there are those of you on the text line, Design My Lifetime Enclosures, and I saw you yesterday stressing how he struggles to see over the middle of the field. Mm-hmm. To which I say, sure, there's been moments where I agree. I question, like, is he seeing this guy in the middle of the field? But you also could make the argument that in last year's offense, they barely had a wide receiver running free over the middle of the field. They were never sent that direction, schematically speaking. And so that's where I struggle with this idea of, well, he's all over the place, he's inconsistent. Because I think if you look at this within a vacuum, you will see that the functional things, and I go back to Nate Tice after Trevor's rookie season, like having to defend him online. If you look at the sample size of, like, this is what you're asked to do in a perfect situation or even a not so perfect situation, the footwork is there, the arm strength is there, the receiver may not be there, or if in the case of Tank Bigsby fumbling the ball, like, then that may happen. And so it's a comedy of errors. That's all to be said that I don't think he's perfect. Mm-hmm. I don't know if he is a top five, top 10 quarterback at this writing, at least based on last season. But when I say last season, and I said this to Mike Dempsey as he made his way out of headquarters, when the Jaguars were 8-3, were people having this conversation? Were people saying, I have questions about Trevor Lawrence. I think he should be benched for the backup. He should be benched for Mac Jones. Not to the extent that they are today.
And that's the thing. The 8-3, if you go game by game, it wasn't necessarily the most impressive wins, and those losses were absolutely atrocious to the Texans and the offense against the 49ers, or sorry, the offense against the Chiefs, and then everything against the 49ers was lacking. But I do think people are going to always put a microscope on Trevor Lawrence because of how he rose to this position. Mm-hmm. People were talking about him when he was in high school as potentially a franchise quarterback. We all watched him at Clemson. The Clemson system is nothing like a pro system, so he was going to take it was going to take time for him to get adjusted to a pro system and the offense that was going to be run. And then he had two different offenses within the first 2 years. And, oh, by the way, the first guy didn't even his first head coach didn't even last the entire season. Mm-hmm. Then he gets Doug Peterson. I think if he had gotten Doug Peterson his rookie season, we would be having a completely different conversation. And most of us are still fully believing in Trevor Lawrence. I am one of them. By the way, my adjective is resilient.
Okay.
I'm going to use that because of everything he's been through. Mm-hmm. I just talked about the Urban Meyer debacle that was originally. Then you have a guy who has to learn a new system. And I wouldn't say he had the best weapons 2 seasons ago. He made, like you said, Mia, he made them better. With
multiple people
Jones,
sat
Christian
at
Kirk,
this table
and said they had threes.
Three,
yep,
two,
all,
three.
Yeah, no number one wide receiver is exactly right. And so I think he elevated those guys. This past season, he went through hell. Like, literally, as a quarterback, you have absolutely no time to get rid of the ball. And, oh, by the way, you're playing hurt then for pretty much half the season. Your best receiver doesn't know where he's going in Calvin Ridley. And your other best receiver gets hurt, like you said, at the 8-3 juncture. To me, he is so incredibly resilient because you know what he didn't do? He didn't throw anyone under the bus. He never came to that podium or in the locker room or what have you and said, I am so sick and tired of not having time to throw the football.
Yeah.
Ryan Tannehill said that last season. Mm-hmm. Said he was, you know, had no time and he was getting destroyed. Trevor Lawrence has never done that. He has always been such a good, I'm going to take the weight of the world, put it on my shoulders, and keep going and keep smiling. Yeah. And so I think we are incredibly lucky to have him. Is Mac Jones talented? Could Mac Jones potentially start for another NFL team one day? Perhaps.
Yeah.
But it's not going to be for the Jaguars unless Trevor Lawrence gets hurt.
Well, and one thing for me, though, is I don't want to take away from the weapons. And I get, like, the Evan Ingram. New York Giants were frustrated with the drops of Evan
yes.
Ingram. Evan Ingram has still dropped some balls here in Jacksonville. There's been those moments. But Evan Ingram was just shy of 800 yards in New York. So, and I think 5-6 touchdowns. He was not like some schmuck. He came here and had a better quarterback. So your numbers should get better if you have a better quarterback than Daniel Jones. Like, that's just what you feel like should happen. Same for Christian Kirk. Christian Kirk only started 11 games and still had just shy of 1,000 yards. And as a wide receiver, too, on the team he was at before Jacksonville. So these weapons that we got, and I know a lot of us, because it wasn't – it's not a Justin Jefferson. It's not a A.J. Brown. It wasn't any of these big names that we're going to talk about, a Tyreek Hill, any of that. But they brought in decent weapons to help him. So, yes, it should have gotten better all the way around. And I think some people were like, okay, well, you did add. You gave him you fixed – and this is 2 years ago because last year they obviously didn't do anything. But you did add onto the offensive line, and you did give him weapons, and you did try to bulk up that defense a little bit. And then, yes, you had that season that was really good. And we talk about – the end of that season, I think this is where people's mindsets are, not technically mine, but where a lot of people thought process is. At the end of that season, let's go back 2 seasons ago with the Chargers comeback. If it didn't go that way, if the end was Trevor threw 4 picks in a playoff game, that conversation last year would have been completely different. But he did do that, so that's why the conversation shifted a little bit. But there were many moments even that year where people were like, is this going to continue to progress and continue to get better? Or are we kind of going to have this guy that, yes, can perform really well at moments, but not all the time? And I think that's where a lot of people's thought process is. I don't know where the Mac Jones comes in this, because I don't see any consistency out of Mac Jones at all whatsoever. So I think that comparing that is weird to me, but having some hesitation on certain aspects of Trevor's game, I get.
Look, Mia, he had 65.6% completion last season and over 4,000 yards. If those were the only stats we look at with what we just talked about, the bad offensive line, all the injuries he played through, the fact that his best receivers were hurt, other than Ridley, who at times didn't know the right route. If we just looked at those, we'd be talking about, wow, that's really impressive. The problem is the 14 interceptions with just the 21 touchdowns. It's those numbers that people are going to focus
on. And he did have Kirk most of the season.
Right. He did have Kirk most of the season, minus the stretch run, which is very true. I think a lot of the struggles last year do go back to the structure of the offense. And guess what, folks? I'm about to play that song again.
No.
Last offseason, Doug Peterson gave a lot more liberty to his offensive coordinator and Trevor Lawrence in creating the offense to their liking, as opposed to Doug being more hands-on.
Yeah. Which we found out the day of the first game.
Yeah.
Yes.
That is the most intriguing part to me, is that we sweated our butts off at training camp for 3 weeks, and at no point were we told, hey, Press Taylor is going to be taking over the offense.
Until that day, and I will never say, because I don't know who leaked that, but I do know there were some other follow-up articles saying Press Taylor could be the next coach of the Chicago Bears. Sorry, Taylor. And I do know who leaked that, and it was the party involved. And so that's all fine and good. I understand trying to promote your brand. I understand trying to promote from within if you're Doug Peterson. But when he sat there at the podium on the day after the season ended at the Miller Electric Center, and he said, I know the problems and I know where they need to be fixed. Yes, he was talking about the defensive coaches who weren't showing up to work. Mm-hmm. He was also talking about...
Ooh, that was salty.
Yeah, but hey, listen, it happens.
You just slid that one in there.
I mean, hey, it happens. So, he addressed that head on, and I believe that the other thing that he realized he had to address was the offense got away from what he wanted it to be.
Mm-hmm.
And so that is where I don't want to say you can't judge Trevor Lawrence based on last year, because that's not the perfect offense for him. The perfect offense was 2022 when he was still learning.
Right, and he was 25 touchdowns, 8 picks in that offense.
Correct.
It's Doug Peterson's first.
Correct. And again, the ball security is a thing. I'm never going to dismiss that until I'm proven otherwise.
Sure.
Which I think, you know, not to rile up the Cowboy fans in Jacksonville, but they'd tell you the same thing about Dak Prescott.
Definitely.
Especially in the playoffs.
And I also think, as much as he's a mercurial figure If you were to tell, you know, Jaguar fans, you know, maybe throw a Super Bowl and a couple more playoff wins in there, if Trevor Lawrence is playing at the level that Dak Prescott has played the last 3-4 years with, again, more playoff wins, you would sign up for that in a heartbeat, would you not? Maybe he's not one of those top 4 or 5 guys.
Yeah.
But in terms of statistical output,
yes,
touchdowns to interceptions in the last 2 years alone, I think you would sign up for that in a heartbeat.
And I think that's maybe what people have to start to accept is you don't have to be that Patrick Mahomes, Josh Allen, Joe Burrow that we've talked about a lot. And even those guys we criticize. Josh Allen has a lot of issues too. He turns over the ball a ton too. But when you talk about that top tier of quarterbacks, usually it involves them. That it doesn't have to be that for you to be able to make run. Look what Detroit just did this last year with Jared Goff. Like, you can have a quarterback in Trevor Lawrence, who we've already seen, like I said, in moments, you just need to see it a little more consistently, be able to be that guy. And so when you have a team that can stay healthy and you have all these parts that really start to click, and let's just hope that Doug says, hey, give me this offense back, because it obviously worked better that way, then you have a team again where you're like, okay, this is the offense we knew it could be.
And to your point, Josh Allen, 29 touchdowns, 18 picks, almost the same exact percentage, completion percentage as Trevor with 66.5 and then 4,300 yards. So that's a guy, like you said, he's also, quote unquote, turnover prone.
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of times when Trevor, especially the fumbles to me, because we always talk only about the interceptions, but like you said, it's more than just that. It's always when he's trying to make a play,
yeah,
and he's trying to his
it's
team's
that hero
not,
ball.
Yeah, and his offense isn't doing anything, so he's lunging, trying to get that extra yard, or you know, and that's where I'm sure he's working on that in the offseason. I'm sure he is well aware, by the way, that the guy that he grew up idolizing in Peyton Manning also had a lot of interceptions when he first started playing as well, and that can mean that you are taking chances.
Yeah, which that's the same thing that Josh Allen does too. That's why he also has 15 rushing touchdowns this season, because
precisely,
he just goes and is like, I'm going to do it if you're not.
Exactly.
And now for something completely different.
Oh.
That just happened. Brought to you by Florida Home AC.
Panthers defensive tackle Derek Brown is signing a 4-year, $96 million extension that includes $63.165 million guaranteed, according to Adam Schefter of ESPN. It's fascinating, ladies. Number one, because we can compare this to some of the contracts that were divvied out in Jacksonville along that defensive front this offseason and will be hopefully passed out in the years to come. But I also find it fascinating knowing that they said goodbye to the Florida State product in Brian Burns, trading him away to New York for pennies on the dollar, for lack of a better term. And also, I'm not really sure if Brown lived up to the hype when many of us here in Jacksonville were clamoring for Jacksonville to draft him with that 9th overall spot back in the 2020 NFL draft.
Yeah, I mean, I think that the Panthers have had a very interesting way to go about their last couple years. And we joke about them taking all of the C.J. Henderson and all of the guys that Jacksonville doesn't want. But they've just had a weird approach. And I think, yeah, when we look at the contracts that you are expecting to pay, this is kind of the league we're living in now, where that you kind of have to, if you have confidence in a guy to be able to continue to play and at least play at a decently high level, you've got to pay him or somebody else is going to. And that's where we're at right now.
I'll give Derek Brown this. The best ability is availability. He's played in all but.
Yeah, he's only missed a few games.
No, he's played in every game. Every game is 4-year career, so
credit
to him for that. The sack production, not perhaps what many thought coming out of college.
Yeah, he has 8 career sacks.
Yeah, 8
he
career sacks.
He was really
sacks.
Good at Auburn. Mm-hmm.
7 tackles for loss last year. I know he's not called upon to necessarily be that pass rusher,
but
it brings to question another topic we can get into at some point, which is that interior pass rush. Mm-hmm. How important is that in today's NFL? How important is it to the Jaguars this season, knowing they signed Eric Armstead, knowing they had signed Devon Hamilton to a hefty extension last offseason in hopes he would create that interior push that maybe doesn't translate to sacks for him, but it translates to sacks for the entire whole.
And that's what I was about to ask, because I'm wondering if maybe that pressure rate is still high, because it's something that obviously we don't see in a lot of times when they're like, oh, you know, 8 sacks and this, because he does have 48 QB hits. So he's obviously still getting near and around the quarterback, just not always getting him down. And that's something we saw especially a couple seasons ago. Obviously, it took that ramp up with Trayvon and Josh Allen last year, but the season before, it felt like just close every time. Like, okay, they're there. They're the quarterback is feeling something, but it wasn't quite all the way getting that full sack. And then you saw that kind of that upgrade last year. And sometimes with those interior guys, like if it's not the best of the best interior guy, they're creating, they're wreaking some havoc there, but you're not always seeing that that directly correlate to a sack number.
He's so if you look into the analytics, he's really good against the run, but not as good getting to the quarterback. But, you know, it just depends on what you want from your defensive tackle position. Yeah. And a lot of times that guy might come off the field in the third and long situation because they know they want to get another guy who's maybe a little bit more athletic out there on the field. I think you bring up a great thing, Taylor, and that is like when people talk about just yards for quarterbacks, it makes me cringe. I'm like, please look at completion percentage.
Yes.
Please. And when it comes
and
to
scoring, because you can't win if you're not scoring touchdowns.
That's true, too. And when it comes to defensive players, people only talk about sacks, and it should be pressure rate. Like that, the amount of times you're getting pressure on the quarterback that's negatively affecting the quarterback. And this, like I said, he's Derek Brown. I'm looking at him now and really like best in the league as far as tackling, best in the league, run stuffing, but 37th as far as QB pressures.
We love your interaction here on Helmets and Heels, especially on what we are dubbing a feel-good Friday.
That's right.
Yes.
They are excited to debut that in the 1 o'clock hour. We love your interaction, whether it's on the text line brought to you by Lifetime Enclosures, which you get can get in on that conversation at 641-1010, as well as on the YouTube chat line where y'all are just lighting it up on a feel-good Friday. Let me read
Did you just use y'all?
Yeah, of course I did. I've been here for 6 years now. I can. I did work at the Academy of Country Music once upon a time. And I was reminded yesterday that that was 10 years ago. So, I'm old.
Trust me, when you realize you graduated from college 20 years ago next month, you really start to
I feel better now. Off the
welcome.
YouTube chat line from Tuck the Fightins, well said. This is a contract year for Trevor. If Balky doesn't pick up his fifth, the Jags always look like all pros in contract years. From Chris, stop trying to place all the turnovers on Trevor. From Jim, the great Brett Favre threw 336 interceptions, 336. And, of course, to counter that on the text line, sounds like excuses for Trevor's inept play.
There you have it. Everyone's going to take it a different way. All right, our countdown to the NFL draft continues. We've got Mike Giardi joining us next to take a look at who the Patriots might select with that number 3 pick. You're listening to Helmets and Heels on 1010 XL on 2.5 FM.
Launch the downloads.
Join the 1010 XL podcast network.
And initiate sequence.
Now you can find all your favorite 1010 XL podcasts in your platform of choice.
Let's fire up the flavor and ignite those appetites. Let's slow down and smell the barbecue. Because all your favorites are smoked for hours and ready for eating when you are. From our famous ribs to slow smoked pork. Enjoy some perfection by the plateful, safely in our dining room or in the comfort of your home. With curbside pickup, drive-through, and delivery. Sonny's Barbecue, local pitmasters since 68.
Lauren Brooks here from Mayport C&C Fisheries. Growing up at the beach, I know good shrimp and oysters when I see them. They're local and they're fresh. That's why Mayport C&C Fisheries is my go-to for both. They have local shrimp in stock 7 days a week. Eat like a local at Mayport C&C Fisheries.
Planning for spring at Lowe's means big savings on outdoor power equipment. And Lowe's knows nothing feels better than free. Buy one select Ego string trimmer, leaf blower, or mower kit. Get one select 56-volt battery free. That's up to a $299 value. Power through spring with Ego, the number one rated brand in cordless outdoor power. Because Lowe's knows home improvement. Valid through 4/3 while supplies last. Selection varies by location.
This is Ace Carline for QC Kinetics. The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics, the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. If you're tired of achy joints, if your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics now. They've got two great locations. Call for a free consultation at 904-274-5522. That's 904-274-5522. And go see them. Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. You can get in. They've got availability. You need to give them a call. Stop dealing with pain in your hips and your shoulders and your knees. Steroids, surgery, drugs, these are no longer your best options. Regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics is transforming lives with innovative treatments that deliver lasting results. Give QC Kinetics a call today. Again, 904-274-5522. Go see them in Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. That's QC Kinetics.
Best Bet is number one. That's right, Best Bet Jacksonville, Orange Park, and St. Augustine have one-card poker, the fastest and easiest card game to learn and play. Play one card at a time, and the highest card wins even money. If the card values are the same, it's time for war, just like the game you remember. You must be 18 years or older to play. More at bestbetjacks.com. That's bestbetjacks.com.
The flagship station of the Jaguars, 1010 XL, 92.5 FM.
Our slogan, "Know Before You Blow," applies to more than just DUI cases. Hi, I'm attorney Lee Lockett of Lockett Law. Battery charges can result in jail time and criminal convictions too, so know before you blow a gasket and hit a loved one or a stranger. Drug crimes like possession of marijuana and cocaine will land you in cuffs too, so know before you blow. In a boating under the influence case, you also have the option to blow or not to blow. So know your options. Know before you blow. Go to knowbeforeyoublow.com now. Offices Jacksonville.
It's the Guggen Open.
Let's play some golf.
Listen to the drill for your chance to play in this year's Coastal Equipment Guggen Open.
Hey, so where do we tee off?
April 15th at Hidden Hills Golf Club.
Four.
Breakfast provided by Chick-fil-A. Enjoy a box lunch from Dandy Foods. Pick up a cigar from Tobacco Cove.
You can do this.
Win great prizes on the course from Edwin Watts Golf.
Thanks to our sponsors.
Andy's Automotive. CSS Outdoor. The Plumbers and Pipe Fitters Union 234. Royal Pest Control and Injury Care Centers.
Did you know Prime Roofing manufactures, fabricates, and installs their metal roofs? If you're thinking about a metal roof, think Prime Roofing. Schedule an estimate today at PrimeRoofingFL.com. That's PrimeRoofingFL.com.
AC's broke, it ain't no joke. Call Florida Home AC.
Florida Home AC. Florida Home AC. Florida Home AC. FloridaHomeAC.com.
Are your kids ready to play this summer? Come check out the Y. Summer is a time for kids to explore new things and expand the limits of their imagination. At the Y Summer Camp, every day is a new adventure. Kids can learn about STEM, arts and humanities, athletic sports, outdoor games, and more. Registration is now open, but space is limited, and spots are filling up quickly. Learn more and find your adventure at fcymca.org. Search Summer Day Camp.
I-9 Sports wants to make sure kids all over the First Coast can enjoy growing up on a field or in a gym. And right now, summer and fall registration is open. So make sure you find out what I-9 Sports offers in your area across Duval, Clay, and St. John's. I9Sports.com. Enter 1010 in the promo code.
Looking for a new or used firearm? Beaches Jewelry and Pawn in Jack's Beach will get you locked and loaded. New firearms coming in weekly. And always looking for used guns. No lines and no waiting. Online at BeachesJewelryandPawn.com.
If your ride is making strange noises, don't wait and make it worse. Come to Action Transmission on Merrill Road. My expert technicians can diagnose the problem and likely fix it fast. Experience the difference at Action Transmission on Merrill Road.
Let's go! It's time for opening night, so don't you dare miss the Jacksonville Sharks' first home game against the IFL defending champions, the Bay Area Panthers, Saturday, April 6th at the ViStar Veterans Memorial Arena. Kickoff, 7 o'clock.
Let's go!
Tickets as low as $15. You can't find Saturday family affordable fun anywhere else. Call 904-621-0700 or go to jacksharks.com. Dust off your boots, grab your cowboy hat for Western Night. Join us at 5 p.m. for Shark Fest, every home game located outside the arena for our pre-game party. Help us rock the tank as we roll out the 2023 NAL Championship banner.
Let's go!
Don't miss our opening game. It's this Saturday, April 6th, 7 o'clock. Let's show them what Jax is bringing to the table at the ViStar Veterans Memorial Arena. Be a part of indoor football fun and exciting non-stop action. For tickets as low as $15, call 904-621-0700. Don't forget your cowboy hats.
Let's go! Let's go!
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Let's ring up another guest on the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
Ready? In 3, 2... One.
The countdown to the draft is on.
I hope you're ready.
Who'll be on the board when the Jaguars pick? Let's find out.
We have reached number 3. Something's up with my microphone the last few days. I keep trying to like turn it down, turn it back up. Hey, it's Friday. We're almost to the weekend, and we are also at number 3 in our countdown to that all-important 17th overall pick, which your Jaguars currently own in the 2024 NFL Draft. And as we are at the New England Patriots spot, or at least as of now where they're slated to pick, who better to speak with than Mike Giardi of the Boston Sports Journal. Mike, thanks so much for joining us on the All-Pro Roofing Hotline.
Thanks for having me.
Appreciate it. And so without further ado, let's get right to it with the 3rd overall pick in the 2024 NFL Draft. The New England Patriots select
a quarterback. Who went number 2?
Jaden Daniels went yesterday at number 2, thanks to Ross Tucker.
Perfect. Drake May at 3. We're running the pick right up there, making sure they get it done. I know there's been a lot of talk about the idea of trading down, but the sense I get from talking to people within the organization is they understand the opportunity here in front of them and the need to find that next quarterback, and Drake May might just fit the bill.
I'm curious, Mike, if, let's say, Washington was to not select a quarterback. I mean, obviously, the expectation is that Caleb Williams will be selected by the Chicago Bears at number 1 overall, given they traded Justin Fields. Between Daniels and May, who are you hearing right now maybe the preference for the Patriots?
So they brought in May today for his 30 visit, and Daniels comes in on Monday. I have heard nothing but good things from inside the organization about both guys. Now, whether this sways them in one direction or another after they meet with both of them, we'll see. But the feeling that I get is that they look at May with the size, the strength, and yes, there are some things that need to be cleaned up, but that they feel they can be cleaned up, that he would be the pick.
I know, Mike, we're looking at the Patriots definitely wanting one of those quarterbacks. Do you see any world where a team gives you guys enough to trade up and take that pick 3?
Yeah, it's been discussed a lot, and obviously Minnesota made the move to get the second first-round pick this year. But, again, the sense I get is that it would have to be 4 first-rounders.
Okay, wow.
So we're not talking about just 11 and 23, but we're talking about 25 and 26 as well. And I don't know that anyone's ever paid that to move up that. And I if you're, say, Minnesota, hey, that's ridiculous. Maybe you can target L.A., who I think wants to move back. Maybe you could target Tennessee, who's obviously had an interesting offseason, and maybe they'd be willing to move a few picks off the spot, and then you go with J.J. McCarthy at that spot. So, yeah, I don't foresee a situation in which someone's willing to give that much up, and therefore that's why I think they stick.
Mike, I want to go back in time since Mac Jones is back in Jacksonville, since this is where he played high school football. What was that career in New England like from your perspective? Obviously, we watched it from here and have a completely different idea.
Yeah, so, I mean, look, that first year was excellent. He was the best of the 5 rookie quarterbacks that year, including Trevor, right? He was in a great situation, unlike what Trevor was with Urban Meyer. And, he had to be managed. Josh McDaniels was in his ear till the last possible second on every single play. But he did some really good things, and you felt like when the year was over – even though they lost by 30 in the playoff game to Buffalo, he was one of the few guys that actually showed up in that game. And you're like, they look like they're in pretty good shape with him. And then they decided to turn the offense over to a defensive coordinator in Matt Patricia and a special teams coach in Joe Judge. And right away, not only could they sense it, but sometimes we get, media, you guys know what you're talking about. I remember watching it going, this doesn't fit them at all. This doesn't look right. And it was that entire training camp was like, they looked terrible. You're like, hey, look, maybe in the first week or so, the defense is ahead of the offense. But eventually the offense finds its footing. The offense never found its footing. That obviously carried over into the season. He got hurt. Zappe comes in. The fans start to take Zappe's side. And it just became a disaster for him that, quite frankly, he never, even with the change in coordinators this past year to Bill O'Brien, that he never was able to kind of dig himself out of. And for someone who's one of his, I guess, superpowers, if you want to call it, is his brain. He short-circuited a lot over the last 2 years, and I don't know if that's just the situation or we were sold a bill of goods that turns out not to be true, but he made a lot of dumb mistakes for a supposedly smart quarterback. And, I like him, and I don't think it's over for him. He needs to kind of get back to his roots a little bit. So I'm happy that he's out of here, and he gets a fresh start. And even though he's the backup, it's probably a good way to sort of reset and find out you know, who he is again and get back to being the Mac Jones that was a first-round pick in 2021.
A fresh start for Mac, a fresh start for the New England Patriots. In case you're just joining us, Mike Giardi on the All-Pro Roofing Hotline selected Drake May with the third overall pick in our countdown to number 17 overall. I'm curious, with Gerard Mayo taking over at the helm, Mike, there's been so many stories done regarding Gerard as almost the extra Belichick son that no one really knew about, but I guess within the walls up there in Foxborough, it was widely discussed. So what changes have you seen already been made that suggest to you this is a new era and perhaps will be a bit more quarterback friendly than the one Bill Belichick built over the last 2 years with Mac Jones?
Well, they're telling us that. And they didn't tell us anything in the previous regime. You had to do your digging and find, you know, multiple sources away from the head coach who didn't like to say anything about anything ever. But clearly, the way they've treated offense, and it wasn't even just the last few years, it goes back to the last couple of years for Brady and sort of what they gave him. And it was kind of remarkable that they were in a Super Bowl one of those years, and then, you know, they were 12-4, and they did lose in the first round of the playoffs to Tennessee in his last year. But, like, again, it goes to show how great Brady was and his ability to elevate even average or below average talent. But, I mean, they've been on that train for a long time. Even now, the you know, the collection of talent that the new quarterback is going to have is subpar. You know, they're in a place where they don't just need one wide receiver, they need two. They don't just need any old tackle, they need a starting left tackle. So there are a lot of things that in this build that it's going to take them. This is not a single year you're going to turn this thing around. This should be a multiple year project. But they've said it. They've talked about weaponizing the offense. They were in the Calvin Ridley hunt, even though, you know, obviously Ridley chose Tennessee. You know, my understanding was they put at least $40 million guaranteed on the table, which, you know, wasn't enough. So I guess I can't give them credit for going the extra mile because they didn't go the extra mile, but at least they understood for the first time in a long time, like, we don't have enough to be good offensively. And even though this guy, Ridley, comes with some questions and the age is not necessarily where you want to pay him to that point, they at least were in the mix and tried to make something happen because they understand we don't have blue chippers. We have to find more. We have to put our future quarterback in a better position.
Yeah, and I think that's one thing we've definitely seen, Mike, is that blueprint that works when you have a young quarterback and how to build around, and some teams just haven't been able to do it, haven't been able to work it out, whether it's not they don't have the money, they don't have the coaching, they don't have the draft picks. But when we go back to that 2021 draft class, and now we look at Mac Jones and Zach Wilson and Justin Fields and Trey Lance, and none of them are in the places where they were drafted, and other than Trevor Lawrence is sitting here, what is that perspective up there of that draft class, including Trevor Lawrence right now?
Well, what that draft class has done is scarred a lot of people who are, I think, from a fan base perspective, there's a fair amount that just want to trade back because they're petrified and they think, like, let's find the quarterback later. Or they saw Michael Penix for one game in the NCAA Final Four, if you will, play great. And they're like, well, it's got to be Penix. And then, you know, they disregard what he did in the championship game and they ignore the fact that he's 24 and has had multiple surgeries on his knees and his shoulder. And, like, they saw that one game and they decided that Penix should be the guy. I actually like Penix, but again, not to pick him there. And I'm not one who feels like, oh, go find your quarterback in the second round. Like, that doesn't generally happen. There's seven teams that made the playoffs this year in the AFC. All of them had a first round quarterback playing for them, with the exception of Mason Rudolph ended up being the starter at the end of the year, but Pickett was the starter to begin with. So I still kind of include him in that mix. I just think you have to jump in. I think people are now skittish. Well, you know, in that case, when you pick Jones, he was the fifth of five quarterbacks. So now they're looking at me and saying, well, because you're the third pick and because the other two teams are going to pick quarterbacks, you're only getting the third best quarterback. Well, what if Washington gets it wrong? What if they should pick May and they pick Daniels? What if they pick McCarthy and you pick like, you don't know. Yeah. What happens when you get in the building and support? I think that was a big thing that being at the league meetings and talking to a bunch of different teams about, you know, how they view the position and what you need to do to be successful. We talked to Matt LaFleur, and he's like, look, you got to support the dude, because what I've seen is guys get scars early in their career and then they're never able to build their confidence back up. And if you support them, you put them in a better position, they understand what's expected of them, that now it's different. And maybe, yes, they will have some moments that, don't go perfectly. That's the way that position goes, right? But that they're easily able to bounce back from that. And that's when you know you've done the good job, and that's when you know you found the right guy who can handle the bad times, because there will be bad times. There's almost, I mean, I know C.J. Stroud, it was pretty much a straight line this year, but, like, there were still a couple moments in there where you're like, that didn't go great. And yet a week or two later, he bounces back and plays the same level that he had been or even better. So That's what you're looking for.
The Jaguars play the AFC East this upcoming season. What do you think of the pecking order? Since obviously the Bills have lost some talent, the Jets should have a healthy Aaron Rodgers. I know you're not high on the Patriots right now, undergoing a lot of rebuilding. And then you've got the Dolphins, another double-digit win team last year.
So I look at it this way. If Rodgers is healthy, and if Rodgers is healthy, if Tyron Smith can play 12, 13 games, if Morgan Moses,
you're good. Yeah, alliteration.
Geez, that was brutal. If he can play, you know, relatively close to a full season, I think that they have the talent. Like, again, if they had just competent quarterback play last year after Aaron goes down, they're probably a playoff team. So now you're getting Aaron back. I got to feel like even if he was the guy he was in his last year at Green Bay, which didn't measure up to what he had been prior, then that's enough to get them in the playoffs. And in my opinion, the way the division is sort of unfolding, you know, what we know of Buffalo right now without Stephon Diggs, you know, they're certainly going to add to the receiver room, but when and who, we don't know. So I would put Jets first, Bills second, Miami third, Patriots fourth. I have questions about Miami, and someone brought this up to me, and have they maxed out what they have with this current group? And obviously they had to let some very good players walk away because of cap concerns and because of Tua's upcoming contract. And then you could make the argument, well, is Tua really worth $50 million a year? Like, is he more the 35-ish Baker Mayfield type? I would say he's more of the 35-ish Baker Mayfield type, but they seem like they're going to do it, so that's going to handcuff them a little bit going forward.
Which I know we have plenty of Miami Dolphins fans out here listening in Jacksonville still, Mike, so I appreciate that perhaps dose of reality that I think because they...
They're screaming at the radio right now. They hate me right now for saying that. How dare I say that?
I think it's reality, though, because I think... Yeah. And we've had this conversation, and we'll leave you with this, and again, thank you so much for your time, but I think that because of the way the Jaguars' season ended... People forget they started out the year 8-3. And in the same vein, because of how the Texans played in the second half of the season, because of the Dolphins, you know, obviously they stumbled down to the finish line, but made the playoffs, and there were excuses built in, but they still made the playoffs. I'm not sure people view their season last year as negatively, perhaps, as Jaguar fans view their own.
I think that is absolutely fair. And I think what we've seen in particular with Tuanon, they are absolutely crazy about that guy, and there is no there's no reasoning with them. So, you know, there's always going to be built-in excuses for him, it seems like, from a section of the fan base down there in Miami.
Mike, one time I was in Denver, and I told a Raiders fan, a diehard Raiders fan, that Derek Carr was terrible. This was like 2 years ago now. He hated me, and I bet he still hates me because I was right. So I understand about making people mad.
Yes, that is exactly how it goes. When I decided about week 4 or week 5 that the Mac Jones era should be over in New England, I got a lot of hate, and now, you know, you're back to this place where you were right, but I'm still going to hate you because I didn't want to hear it at that point.
Exactly.
No Mac Jones in the AFC East, but we have Tuanon and AA Ron, and we also have Mike Giardi covering all things Patriots and AFC East. Thank you so much, Mike, for joining us on the All-Pro Roofing Hotline.
Thank you. Anytime.
There he goes, Mike Giardi, Boston Sports Journal. You can find him on X at Mike Giardi. That is our countdown to 17 as we are going day by day during the work week, folks. Unfortunately, we do get the weekends off.
Saturday,
and so therefore, we are 17 days away from the NFL draft, or I guess now 14 days as our countdown began on Wednesday. Excited to be joined by representatives for the teams picking 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th. Yes, that's 5.
next
All
week.
Next week as well. This is Helmets and Heels on 1010XL and 92.5 FM.
home of the Jaguars. Follow every play, interview, and press conference.
You know, we're really working, trying to get better.
1010XL, home of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
At Honda, we appreciate all the comparisons to other vehicles. And no matter how many times they compare their vehicles to a Honda, only a Honda is a Honda. Remember, value, quality, safety. There is no substitute. Visit your local Honda dealer now and experience the difference.
The 2024 draft is almost here.
The Jaguars are now on the clock.
Join us at Evercore Stadium Thursday, April 25th for the official draft party presented by Donovan Air Electric and Plumbing. Be there as the Jaguars make the 17th overall pick, and don't miss the unveiling of the official 30th season logo that you voted on. We're getting the party started at 7 p.m. Tickets are free, so register today at jaguars.com/draft party. We can't wait to see you there.
The Jacksonville Jaguars select...
After consulting with several orthopedic specialists about my constant knee pain, I chose Southeast Orthopedic Specialist and Dr. Chris Swanson to handle my surgery. Their professionalism let me know this team was the one for me. The surgery was very successful, and if I ever have a future knee, I'll continue to trust Southeast Orthopedic Specialists to take care of me.
Relieve pain and get back to life.
SOS.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
Crosser here. When it comes to the business of selling your home, there's one promise I can give you that will deliver, and that promise is ChadAndSandy.com. That's Chad, A-N-D, Sandy.com. How do I know this promise is guaranteed? Because they say so, and then they deliver. You see, Chad and Sandy guarantee your home sold at an agreed-upon price and deadline, or they will buy it. So whatever problems you think you're having selling your home, there is your simple solution. They're going to buy it if it's not sold for exactly what you want. Mortgage rates have lowered going into the spring selling season. Now is the time to maximize your equity, and you can do it with the real estate team of Chad and Sandy. They have a plan and the experience to sell your home fast for maximum cash this spring. John and Ursula in Green Meadows wrote in, we weren't in great health, decided to downsize to an easier place to manage. After 185 days, our home failed to sell. We went to Chad and Sandy, sold in 12 days. You can too at ChadAndSandy.com.
This date in sports history is brought to you by Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
On April 5th, 1959, at the 23rd Masters Tournament, Art Wall Jr. wins his only PGA Tour major victory, one stroke ahead of Gary Middlecoff.
I'm Taylor Rose with our Remedy Staffing Westside office off of Normandy Boulevard. We are helping great people find great jobs. Remedy has helped some of the best employers in Jacksonville find talented job seekers like you for over 25 years. Our current job openings range from entry-level distribution center pickers to equipment operators. Apply today at remedygoodjobs.com. Don't wait. Apply at remedygoodjobs.com now.
When you hear Florida Gators baseball on 1010XL, it's brought to you by Renewal by Anderson, the official window and door replacement partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars. And Farrah and Farrah, the official personal injury law firm of the Jaguars.
If you're an experienced, skilled plumber or welder that's MedGas certified and you're tired of working for a company that just doesn't treat you right, Local 234 is the place for you. Their pay is the best in the business. You'll walk away with $35.09 an hour in your pocket, with benefits that's just over $50 an hour. Local 234 has been around since 1901, and that means something. Visit ua234.com to send your resume. Local 234, make the right connection.
Jimerson Burr is a full-service, Florida-based commercial law firm dedicated to helping businesses manage risk, maximize opportunities, and move their company forward. Jimerson Burr attorneys are business-oriented lawyers equally comfortable as community leaders, private transaction counselors, or courtroom advocates. If you have a legal issue of any kind affecting your business, contact the firm at 389-0050 or jimersonfirm.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah and Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
Story time on Helmets and Heels. We're coming back from break. Taylor and I look at each other and we say, oh, yeah, yeah, we're leading with the finger guy. And Lauren Brooks looked at me, absolutely mortified. As I said,
referring to someone on the text line who sent a text, designed by Lifetime Enclosures, about something with, that's all they tell me, just said fingers are involved. And we're about to have Mike Girardi on. And I said, absolutely not. You are not mentioning whatever this text says before we have Mike on. Please. Please.
I think Mike would have enjoyed hearing about 914, the finger guy. Maybe I got to change his name on the text line designed by Lifetime Enclosures. He says, at this point, Mia, I would let someone cut off my finger for a guaranteed Super Bowl for the Jaguars next season. I am serious. I will sign a contract, just not my thumb or middle finger. Ring finger will be fine. Single for life, Leo
single
style.
Life. There you go. I mean, that is a very interesting way to look at things.
That could be a fun question one day.
Sure,
like, what
absolutely.
Would you do for the Jaguars to
I feel
win
like
a
Jaguars today has asked that question before, but maybe like, what would you give up? I don't know if it was like, I'd cut a limb off.
I just love how this happens randomly on Friday, April 5th. I would cut off my finger for a Super Bowl for the Jaguars.
That is a very committed person. I support your dedication and passion. I have a mangled finger, but I'm still not willing to cut that off.
I jammed my finger one time, and that was so painful.
Oh, it's so painful. I've jammed several fingers. The one that's mangled, it's because it was dislocated, but I didn't realize it was dislocated. I went to the doctor, and they told me it wasn't broken, and I was free to carry on about my day, but instead I needed actual surgery, and I didn't have it.
I probably should have prefaced the way the finger conversation came up. Was because we asked you, our Helmets and Heels listening nation, which we do have to come up with a name for you guys. So if you have an idea, 641-1010 is the number to reach us at. So make sure you respond with that. Hi, Press Box. Nice to see you on the text line designed by Lifetime Enclosures.
Do we like the heel lights?
Coach Campo had a good name.
Okay.
I forget. He came up with one once upon a time. So we may have to ask him. But if you have an idea, hit us up at 641-1010. And the finger guy... That came about because we asked you, our listening nation, if you could give us one word to describe Trevor Lawrence as he gets ready to enter year four of his NFL career, what would that one word be? 641-1010 is the number to reach us at. You can also leave a comment on our YouTube live stream. Just visit at 1010XL Video on YouTube.
Buckle up your chin strap.
Blitz! You gotta blitz him!
1010XL.
You blitz all night!
Jacksonville Sports Radio.
We are gonna blitz like Dick Butkus.
Mia here, and if you're still in the hunt for a sports book to call home, bet the nonstop action of the madness with MyBookie. MyBookie is a one-stop shop for all your sports betting and casino needs, complete with a real-life Vegas experience right from the comfort of your phone. Take your viewing experience to the next level with real-time live betting that lets you stream and bet the games right from the MyBookie website. Sign up now and take advantage of a generous welcome bonus on your first deposit, all the way up to $1,000. Put in $200, get $300 ready to play instantly using promo code 1010XL. And the fun doesn't stop there. You'll get up-to-the-minute odds, props, and this week's expert predictions to help you decide who to put your money on. Put in $200, get $300 ready to play instantly using promo code 1010XL. The best part about MyBookie? You can bet on anything, anytime, from anywhere. Use promo code 1010XL to secure your welcome bonus today, only with MyBookie.
Hey folks, Rick Ballew here for John's Auto. They've been a staple in Jacksonville going all the way back to 1985. At John's Auto, they service all makes, all models, cars, trucks, diesel, you name it, they do it. Whether it's routine maintenance or a complete engine overhaul, call John's Auto on Arlington Road. That's 904-743-3857 or go to johnsautomotivejax.com.
Men, suffering from erectile dysfunction or PE? Frustrated taking pills that don't work? Here's a message from Prime Men's Medical Center.
I'm Dr. Simovitz. Prime Men's Medical Center offers breakthrough treatments with men lasting longer than ever without pain or surgery.
Call now. Your consultation and first treatment are free. You'll see instant results right in the office. Call Prime Men's Medical Center now. 904-664-8217. That's 904-664-8217.
DivorceMenOnly.com. This is Kenny Lay of Kenny Lay & Associates. Our firm specializes in representing men in family law.
That's all we do. That's our only focus. We can help with all of your family law needs, such as divorce, custody, alimony, and child support. For over a decade, we have helped thousands of men with these types of issues. We even have an appellate division ready to challenge a judge's ruling. If you need a family law attorney, go to divorcemenonly.com. Divorcemenonly.com. Offices, Jacksonville.
The flagship station of the Jaguars. WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
I'm here with Danny Van Sickle, director of the Electrical Training Alliance. Danny, tell me about your program.
Hey, Rick. We're a five-year electrical apprenticeship. Our students start out making over $40,000 a year, and right now graduate making over $90,000 a year, including benefits. There is no tuition or no student debt. You just have to apply and get accepted.
Did you say no tuition and no student debt?
You heard that right, Rick. Once you're accepted to the program, your only costs are the books and the course fees, about $800 a year.
That sounds like an amazing opportunity. How can I learn more?
Just go to etajax.org, and you can apply there.
Apply by May 23rd.
Hey, Glenn here with B&B Oil with Dylan from March Motor. Hey, Dylan, how does B&B Oil help you guys at the dealership?
If you have a dealership and don't want to worry about the hassle of credit cards or fuel vouchers floating around, have B&B Oil put a tank on your lot. It allows us to control who gets fuel and cuts out the worries of credit cards, and it helps us deliver the car faster. B&B Oil also meets our shop needs with lubricants as well. Call Glenn or check out the website, bb-oil.com.
This is Molly McDonald with your 1010XL Southeast Orthopedic Specialist Local Sports Update, brought to you by Chad and Sandy Real Estate. College baseball is back on the mound tonight as the Florida Gators travel up north to the Midwest to take on the Missouri Tigers. Florida's starting pitcher tonight will be Brandon Neely, throwing out the first pitch at 7 o'clock, followed by Liam Peterson starting Saturday and Jack Caglione on Sunday. You can listen to the Gators versus Missouri three-game series all weekend long on 1010 AM. Continuing in the outfield are the Jacksonville Jumbo Shrimp, who are up in North Carolina, leading their six-game series against Durham, winning the last two out of three games and looking to wrap up this weekend with the series win. Hockey is also on the road as the Jacksonville Icemen skate their way up to South Carolina, ready to battle against the Stingrays tonight at 6:05. It's 71 degrees at 1 o'clock, time and temp, brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
During Helmets and Heels, you're going to hear that song. That would be Rihanna. And that means it's Feel Good Friday time. Ladies, Feel Good Friday, people can participate if they so desire. We are just going to tell you what is making us feel good on this Friday. And you are more than welcome to tell us what's making you feel good. I will kick us off. I have two things this Friday for Feel Good Friday. One, my mom has noticed that there are more and more people who maybe homeless or just maybe begging for money and things like that. And so she has put together bags for all of these people with water and snacks. And that way, if they need water or if they are hungry, she has the bag right there ready for them. And so that made me feel good that she's thinking of others. And yeah, she gave me my first one yesterday. So I'm excited to
Did you tell her I'm homeless?
That may have sparked the whole conversation. Yes. I need a bag for Taylor. So Taylor, the bag is actually for you. But no, I'm excited for other people to share what's making them feel good. My other one is last night, the Jax River Jams. If you have not been to downtown Jax River Jams, the concerts are free. So make sure you get to one. They have four. Last night was the first one. It was Rodney Atkins was the headliner. I've been almost every year. They are just fantastic. So shout out to downtown Jacksonville. And you can find the schedule on their website or on their Instagram, DG Jax. But so much fun. The weather is usually literally perfect like it was last night. A little chilly, so bring a jacket. But it's just great to have free music. And somebody like that, Rodney Atkins.
Definitely. I have a couple also. So one, I want to read some of these that we went through, our names for our listeners. Because there's some good ones.
They make you feel good.
Yes. So one from the 3336, they said the heel yaz.
Instead of hell yeah.
You could just say like heel yeah.
I do like that.
I love it. The other one was, what one was that made us laugh? It was the
heel billies.
The heel billies. That was a good one too.
I also texted Heeligans.
Someone else said, Heeligans. And then a Heelys is another one. So a lot of those coming in. So keep sending us those, our listener names. But
somebody. And then we'll have to pick one, by the way.
Yes. And then we'll pick one eventually. But then we just got another one there. My Feel Good Friday from the 8177 said, sunshine, cold beer. Thank you, Lord. I'm like, yes, amen.
It is. This weather, I said it earlier this week, this is the type of weather that you live for.
Oh, my goodness. And
this is why you moved to Florida, folks.
Definitely.
Yes. Our weather, Mia, I know you posted something about it. Like, this is the best time to live in Jacksonville is March and April. And before the full heat comes in, I can certainly understand that.
Mm-hmm.
It is literally perfect outside.
Yes. And then so number two for me is I have a little clip that I want to play from my nephew because he is 3.5. Sweetest, like my biggest fan in the entire world, and he's so cute. So my brother was in the car on Tuesday and had helmets and heels on, and Bubby knows my voice, so he was like, oh, is that Aunt Tay? And asked my brother to turn up the radio, and then so he just said on a whim a very sweet little sentiment. So my brother was like, wait, I need to record this, say that again for Aunt Tay. So I wanted to play this clip because it was so sweet.
Hey, what you want to tell Aunt Tay?
I love you and
you're
doing great.
Oh, you're doing great.
He's
so cute.
Well, I have heard that, and as I know y'all have, all week long, that people are like, you guys are rocking it, and we love the show, and so thank you.
And even for those of you still yelling into the text line, we love you too. You also make me feel good. I feel like an idiot because I misread our text, and I thought we were doing this in the final segment of the 1 o'clock hour. Oh, so you guys must have been very confused when off air. I'm like, hey, so let's do it like in the 12 and the 1, and you both were like, look, and I'm like, oh, well, it's because we're doing it now. Makes a lot of sense at 1 o'clock because so many of you, I know from my 2 years on XL Primetime, 1 o'clock, you're getting ready for that weekend.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Maybe you're checking out a little early from work. And so I like this 1 o'clock feel good. Hit us up at 641-1010 with what's making you feel good and hopefully stories like hearing from Taylor's nephew firsthand that can make you feel good. My feel good is I got to participate in my first Generation W Summit this morning.
Awesome.
Shout out to Donna Orender, the former WNBA commissioner, who of course is the founder of Generation W, for inviting me. And so many just inspiring speakers, both men and women, in attendance. I texted Kevin and I said, well, I don't think I've ever seen so many pink blazers in one setting, and today was the one day I didn't wear mine, and so I thought on Wednesdays we wear pink. I'm just kidding. That may be a segment at some point on this program, too.
I did wear pink on Wednesday, just for the record.
Yeah, we've been workshopping that, and it was just so inspiring, and I think regardless man or woman, I was so upset, even though I'm very excited to spend, you know, 2 hours with y'all on the radio. I was very upset because I had to leave in the middle of the negotiation discussion with one of the world-renowned negotiators who runs the Kellogg School of Management and Northwestern and has negotiated $6 billion deals.
Wow.
And I was like, dang, like, this is, you know, nothing about, you know, it's female power. Yes, because, of course, we know women are less likely to negotiate a salary raise, a title raise that met their male counterparts. But I just in general, I was like, man, I'm learning so much that, like, I don't want to leave, but I'm still excited to spend 2 hours with you guys. And I'm also very excited, at 9:30 p.m. to watch the Iowa women's basketball team take on UConn.
So for years, I've asked you, you know, your background, not for years, but when I first met you, I asked you about your background. And then for years now, I know you're not really a fan of most teams. However, Iowa women's basketball, you are. So tonight, Florida Gymnastics participates in the regional finals. I am already nervous. And gymnastics is a nerve-wracking sport to begin with because of all the intricacies, especially the beam, the balance beam. How nervous are you or not at all?
I said it to Taylor yesterday. I'm less nervous because akin to Purdue on the men's side, I think the pressure on Caitlin Clark is, yes, to win a national title, to finally win the big one. And to
beat Paige Beckers. I feel like that's a whole other story.
Right. Can you really call her the GOAT if she doesn't win it all? I get that. But I think akin to Zach Edey and Purdue, who, of course, also have the weight of the world on their shoulders because Virginia lost to a 16 seed and then won it all. Doesn't Purdue have to match that?
Mm-hmm.
I think, but they were so excited for the Final Four. Like, the Final Four was, like, the destination for them. That institution hadn't been in 43 years. that was the focal point. And so I think for Iowa, too, getting to the Final Four, there's a sigh of relief. I think just getting out of the round of 32, it sounds so like minuscule. Mm-hmm. But for a team that got upset 2 years ago in the round of 32 on their home floor, getting away from Carver-Hawkeye Arena, getting to the regional because the first two rounds of the women's tournament are at home courts.
Yeah.
I think that that allowed them to play so free against Colorado and against LSU. And so I'm not nearly as nervous as I was Monday against LSU. That was, you know, because I think I was nervous because Iowa was a one-point favorite. And I was like, I don't know about that. Mm-hmm. That's a Well, they're 2.5-point favorites tonight, and I feel a little less nervous.
Yeah.
And maybe, I don't know, like, I root for Paige Beckers. I root for UConn. I think her story is incredible. I mean, can you imagine, again, regardless of sport, you're the National Player of the Year, the first ever freshman to win National Player of the Year, and then you can't finish the next two seasons because of injuries. You don't know if you're ever going to play basketball again.
Yeah.
And to now make it to the Final Four, like, that's – she worked her butt off physically, emotionally. Oh, and by the way, she's one of seven healthy scholarship players. UConn has just been ravaged by injuries the last 3 years, and so credit to them for making it to the Final Four.
In the Battle of the Carolinas tonight, 7 p.m., does South Carolina win it easily?
Oh, yeah. That's what I said to Tommy Mack as he walked out the door. I said it's a sin that ESPN couldn't change the programming lineup, not just for my own sleep schedule and for so many. That was the first thing my dad texted me after Iowa won. It was like relief. And he goes, my goodness, they're ruining my sleep schedule. The fact that Iowa-UConn, the premier game, if you may, tips off at 9:30. But South Carolina, I was just checking the lines at my bookie, are 11.5-point favorites over NC State. I think they cover and then some. And so that's where my... I hope for the sake of the women's game, people don't just completely tune that one out because they're so, you know, but hopefully they come back for that 9:30 tip. I think there's enough star power that they will. But yeah, I think South Carolina is going to run crazy.
What about those two different games? Because they played Indiana, barely scraped by Indiana, and then ended up kind of rolling over Oregon State. So is it, do you think the Indiana game was more of a fluke, or were that two different teams that were showing up between those two games?
So two things. The game before that against North Carolina, they doubled them up. I think it was like, you know, like 60-20 or something at halftime. Like, it was some absurd number. North Carolina's a pretty good outfit. The Indiana game, perhaps you can say, well, they were coming off a game in which they cruised in the round of 32.
Got a little comfortable.
Having watched Iowa play Indiana the last few years, all the credit in the world to the program they've built out there from where it was when I was covering the Big Ten in women's basketball 6 years ago. It's an elite program. Mackenzie Holmes is an All-American center. And yes, she lost Grace Berger, her running, or not even her running mate, but her point guard last year to the WNBA, but they've been able to reload. And so there's some pretty good talent on that Indiana team, and that's no knock on Oregon State, who I'm not as familiar with just because outside of USC, I haven't watched a ton of Pac-12 women's basketball. But I just think that the caliber of play in the Big Ten is underrated because historically where it's been outside of Ohio State and Maryland.
All right, so Taylor, admittedly not the biggest college basketball fan, will you be locked in tomorrow during NC State versus Purdue at 6:09 p.m., and then the later game, Alabama-UConn at 8:49?
I'll definitely be locked into those games. Once March Madness starts, I do watch a lot more college basketball than I do the rest of the season. And to me, I love, like, I think I'm cheering so hard for NC State just because
I figured DJ Burns had your heart.
It just adds that little extra element for me. And once I have something extra to root for, then there's a whole other element to why I'm watching the sport. Like, I already enjoy watching, and if it's on TV, I'll watch it. But will I go out of my way to watch certain games? No. But to go out of my way to watch DJ Burns, I may just do that. And I think that I have a lot of my family actually graduated from Purdue, a lot of my family from Indiana. So they're all diehard Purdue fans, and they've been waiting for this, obviously, for a while. So we've been all kind of going back and forth with that this week, too. So there's definitely a couple on each side of that game for me. There's something, a little extra investment for it. But, Mia, if you had to... If you had to pick one of the NC State upsets, which one would you say is more likely?
Well, I picked NC State on the men's side, both in the Sweet 16 and the Elite Eight last week. So do I keep
roll with it?
I mean, that's the crazy part. Like, I said it during a My Bookie read last week, and as I heard myself say it, I was like, did I really just pick NC State? And then I was like, well, I'm picking with my heart. I do think it was like a pretty big line, and so I'm like, they could cover that.
I thought you were about to say a lie.
No, not lie. Which, by the way, the line, speaking of on My Bookie, is down to 5. I do think there's a world in which NC State can cover that. Mm-hmm. I also think there's a world in which Purdue is just maniacs on a mission. Although, I don't know, we didn't play it, but I'm not sure if you guys saw Zach Edey's post-game whatever we want to. It was an interview, mm-hmm. But it was cathartic.
Oh.
He may or may not have dropped some expletives on live national television, but that's
like Sherrone Moore, the Michigan.
Correct, akin to Sherrone, right? Yeah. I would equate it to Sherrone Moore, and I think akin to Sherrone Moore, although maybe on a bit higher degree of severity, since Sherrone Moore was just crying about Jim Harbaugh, and Zach Edey was crying about the fact that he got beat by a 16 last year, and now they finally were going to the promised land, and he started calling out coaches who didn't recruit him, that were at IMG when he was there, and just ignored him. And I'm not saying that they're going to get ahead of themselves, but clearly they took this to heart a lot more than we thought, and so I'm not going to pick the Wolfpack to win, Taylor, because I just think Purdue really is on a mission. But wouldn't it be a wonderful story?
I would love it.
It would, and
it would be wild if we had NC State, Alabama. Like, that is a football, NC State maybe not as good, but certainly.
Or UConn, NC State. Because I think UConn, NC State would be the ultimate David versus Goliath. And that's what draws people to the NCAA tournament, men or women. It's the idea of a school that came out of nowhere that had only 17 wins, had 14 losses 3 weeks ago. They weren't going to even play in the NIT, and now they're playing in the NCAA tournament.
That's what happens when you win your conference tournament, and that's what NC State did as a double-digit seed. They were a 10 seed in the NCAA or in the ACC tournament, now obviously an 11 seed in the overall tournament. And yeah, like Foyer said, isn't all of America rooting for NC State and DJ Burns? The answer is yes, America is.
And before we switch gears a little bit here, Lauren, there's a lot of folks feeling good on our text line, Designed by Lifetime Enclosures.
Oh, tell me all about
it. I want to make sure.
Feel Good Friday.
I want to make sure we hit some of these. Let's begin with 651. My Feel Good Friday is knowing the Orlando Magic will be in the NBA playoffs for the first time since 2020. I know there's still a couple more games, but I'm feeling ecstatic. Round of applause and also a shout out.
And yes, absolutely a shout out.
To RJ Saunders, Open Gym, 11 a.m. Sundays right here on the Superstation. RJ, what do we have coming up on Sunday's program?
On Sunday's program, we will be talking quite a bit. I'm going to dig into Bronny James as elected to put his name in the hat for the NBA draft. Is he going to go? Is he not going to go? Is his dad putting him up to this? We'll discuss that. Also, I'm very excited about this. Shout out to Leon for doing this. Chucky Atkins, former NBA player, former Los Angeles Laker, will be joining us on the program to speak on the Orlando Magic. He foresaw that the Orlando Magic were going to have a spectacular year this year. He said everybody laughed at him, and now who's laughing now, in his opinion? And we'll discuss all that and more on the program on Sunday.
I'm actually really interested in that Bronny James thing and your opinion. So I may be listening on Sunday, RJ, because
are you going to call in? Are you going to text in?
And just be hello. Like, what is going on? Hello, it's Taylor from Jacksonville. Because I know he suffered cardiac arrest in summertime. I believe it was in July. But this season, I think he's only averaging like 4.8 points a game. It just like so. I'm interested in that, RJ.
And that may be his ceiling, by the way.
Yeah.
I had friends texting me as soon as the news broke, like. The thing with Bronny James is that he can play in the NBA. I truly believe he can play in the NBA. However, I believe he needs a little more seasoning at the college level because I think his ceiling in the NBA is as a glue guy.
Yeah.
He's never going to be more than a 10 points per game, 5 rebounds per game, 7 assists per game type of guy. Like that's who he is. There's a role in the NBA for him. There's a place for him. I'm not so sure it's leaving after one season from the college ranks and then being drafted somewhere and being thrown into the fire. That's just not his style.
Yes.
Well, I know the whole point was LeBron and Bronny played together at some point in time, and LeBron
they're
has
rushing
recently
it a
said,
little bit, maybe.
Well, it's important to know
he doesn't have much time left.
Yeah, and
playing time, not
he's alive. He's alive and well. But no, I think it's important to note too that Bronny is maintaining his eligibility, and he will enter the transfer portal, which is because Andy Enfield, the head coach of USC, was let go.
Uh-huh.
Eric Musselman, the former coach at Arkansas, now is back in Southern California. I think Mus actually might be like an ideal coach for Bronny, knowing his style and getting up and down the court and how he values his guards. And I think it would be a good thing for him to stay at USC, but maybe there's been rumors of Baylor having interest, rumors of Michigan State, maybe Ohio State, of course, because of their roots in Ohio. I'll be very curious to see, because I do think he tests the waters of the NBA draft, which, listen, if you have a college basketball player out there, whether they're a low major D1 or they're Zach Edey, I can't stress enough the opportunity the NBA gives you to declare, go through the draft process, get feedback while maintaining your eligibility and go back to school.
Mm-hmm. Both Chaz Lanier locally, UNF's Chaz Lanier and JU's Robert McCray are doing that exact thing. Yeah. They both declared and then, like you said, test the waters, but they can certainly come back to their respective schools. And the other thing, Foye Oluokun joined us yesterday in case you missed it, and that interview is on demand. We appreciate the Jaguars linebacker once again for taking so much time with us. One thing he mentioned is, you know, with the transfer portal, it can be really good for mid-majors. And that's absolutely true. You can go play, whether it's here locally or elsewhere, you can go get 40 minutes or not exactly 40, but, you know, close to it, 30 to 35 minutes and put up great numbers. And then you're able, if you so desire, to transfer up, so to speak, to a Power 5, Power 6 program. And then you could also make some more money when it comes to the NIL. All right, we're going to switch gears, like Mia said, back to football because – I feel like everybody has an opinion on quarterbacks, right? That's the one position that everybody, whether good or bad, has an opinion. We talked about Trevor Lawrence to start the show. We each gave an adjective or a word to describe Trevor.
We have plenty on the text line, by the way, which we will read some of those as well.
We will get to that. So right now, Trevor Lawrence is backup quarterback. By the way, our words, Taylor said inconsistent. Mia's was kind of turnover prone.
I'm going to just say question.
Question, okay.
That's what we're going to say.
And then mine was resilient.
It's hard to pick one word. I need a sentence.
It is really hard. That's why I posed the question.
Well, people are going to yell at me.
To challenge you, make you think. By the way, on the one of the tweets that someone just sent us, Figgy Small said determined. That's his word for Trevor Lawrence. I think that's a really good one. But so Trevor now has a different backup quarterback. Well, I suppose C.J. Beathard is still here, and maybe he'll stay here if the Jaguars keep three quarterbacks. We'll see on that. But Mac Jones, the Jaguars did trade for Mac Jones, the former Patriots quarterback, and he was on Jaguars.com yesterday and shared what kind of player the Jaguars are getting.
Honestly, just a guy who loves football, and I'm excited to be here and get back on track and in my hometown. It's just a great opportunity for me, but I'm going to give it everything I got, and I'm excited to work with the quarterbacks and just learn from everybody and bring my personality to the room.
I have to say, watching that video, Mac Jones is the happiest backup quarterback you will ever find in the National Football League.
I mean, I'm sure, and we just heard from Giardi and how messy things got. People chanting for Zappy Hour, and it was just
Happy Zappy.
Happy Zappy, yeah. Like all of those things, and probably we kind of saw that he almost got like what seemed booted from the locker room at certain times during his time there. So I'm sure in general he wanted a fresh start, but to be able to come where he did play high school football, family, like you have there's. It's familiar. All
his
of
dad picked him up from his first press conference with his mom.
Adorable.
With his mom.
My parents are here. They're going to be picking me up.
That was hilarious. But I'm sure he's happy. And also, he's in sunny 75 degrees over snow right now in April. And I know not everybody cares about that, but it is like, I'm sure in his head, he was like, get me out of this like gloom. And that is in everything.
Physical and figuratively speaking. Yes. I also think, going from not having, and yes, Bill O'Brien, certainly former offense coordinator at Alabama before going back to the Patriots. So he did have an offensive mind in his ear last year, albeit only for however many games that he played. I would think having Doug Peterson, his more sunny disposition in general, and also him having been a former quarterback, and by all accounts, Doug bringing Mac to Jacksonville to be a backup is, number one, good value, because you would have taken a developmental quarterback with that sixth-round pick. Instead, you have a guy who has 40-plus NFL starts. Pretty darn good value.
Yeah.
And secondly, because I truly believe that Doug, akin to when he was in Philadelphia and they developed Nate Sudfeld, they clearly developed Jalen Hurts to an extent before he was let go. I think Doug kind of wants to create almost the quarterback rehab that we've seen Kyle Shanahan build out on the West Coast. Mm-hmm. Sam Darnold, by all accounts, even if the Minnesota Vikings draft a quarterback in the first round of the NFL draft, he's probably starting day one. And that's a tribute to Shanahan and the work they did to rehab him. I know Trey Lance didn't work out. It's okay. It happened. Jimmy Garoppolo still somehow is making money after being let go. And so I think that Doug and his disposition combined with that idea of, hey, come here, reset.
Yeah.
In Mac's words, get the train back on the tracks.
Right.
That's an appealing thing.
Well, and also go back to, I remember, because we talked a ton about he got to play for Corky Rogers. Then he got to play for Nick Saban. And then we were like, wow, it's perfect. He gets to go play with Bill Belichick. And it almost looks like that year one, it looked like it was that. It was the perfect scenario for Mac Jones. And that kind of fell apart that next year because of how Bill almost just left him in the wilderness without having any offensive-minded guy to try and guide him in year two. They were just like, you did good in year one. Here you go. Take off. And now coming to a city with someone like Doug Peterson, who does have that type of mindset that Mia was saying, it's best for him. And I know we kind of mocked the when he came here, and a lot of people were like, I don't understand the signing, including myself. But for Mac Jones and his career, it probably is one of the best things that could have happened for him.
Yeah, certainly. All right, let's get to some of these texts and tweets. Chrissy's one word to describe Trevor Lawrence is sexy.
Oh, yes.
Well, so, okay. Don't know if you read that one right, or we're listening to the program, but hey.
Chrissy, hey, you know what? Chrissy thinks that of her quarterback. That is perfectly fine. By the way, Allison agrees with Taylor. Her word is inconsistent as well.
I'll rattle a couple of these off the text line. Yep. From Woody, time. From 575, subpar. From 529, generational. Hey, now, 529, you cheated. You sent us two words. You said consistency and generational. Well, you got to pick one or the other, my guy. We got Motivated Army, although that may have been a name for the Helmets and Heels listeners and not for the one word for Trevor Lawrence.
That's probably accurate because that's also not one word.
And then off the YouTube chat line, inconsistent from Floyd. So we have consistent and inconsistent.
Yes, which, yeah. I mean, when it boils down to, like Taylor said, when it boils down to just one word, when you could use paragraphs to describe someone, it can be challenging. But I appreciate everybody's feedback, and certainly we hope that the word that we are going to use moving forward is champion.
Yes.
That's the word we'd like to describe Trevor Lawrence as. Super Bowl MVP and Super Bowl champ. Yes.
A year from now, that's the word we want to
use. A year from now, how fantastic would that be? I don't even allow myself to like have those types of thoughts, Taylor, because 2017 was, as you know, so magical that I like reliving it in my mind is like, it's such a tease because we're so far from there, at least how it feels right now.
Yeah.
Hope. From 264.
All right.
I think that's a good sentiment to head into our first break of the 1 o'clock hour with.
I think so.
That's what they called our defense last year.
That's also what we call a feel good Friday, having hope. We like that too.
That's absolutely right. All right. We've got more to do. We are going to talk to Bonnie Jill Laughlin when we return, the first and only female NBA scout, and she wrote a book in a league of her own celebrating female first in sports. So, of course, that's apropos for our show right here, Helmets and Heels on 1010XL on 2.5 FM.
1010XL takes you inside the program director's office with Dan and Jeff.
You call yourselves professionals.
The drill.
You all got your heads so far up your butt.
Mornings on 1010XL.
I have never, ever seen.
This is Ace Carline for QC Kinetics. The future of medicine is here at QC Kinetics, the nation's leader in regenerative medicine. If you're tired of achy joints, if your joint pain is keeping you from doing what you love, you need to call QC Kinetics now. They've got two great locations. Call for a free consultation at 904-274-5522. That's 904-274-5522. And go see them, Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. You can get in. They've got availability. You need to give them a call. Stop dealing with pain in your hips and your shoulders and your knees. Steroids, surgery, drugs, these are no longer your best options. Regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics is transforming lives with innovative treatments that deliver lasting results. Give QC Kinetics a call today. Again, 904-274-5522. Go see them in Mandarin and Ponte Vedra. That's QC Kinetics.
Mia here, and if you're still in the hunt for a sports book to call home, bet the nonstop action of the madness with MyBookie. MyBookie is a one-stop shop for all your sports betting and casino needs, complete with a real-life Vegas experience right from the comfort of your phone. I know, it's the question everyone's been asking me this week. Will Iowa advance to the national title game on the women's side for a second straight NCAA tournament? The line has moved, folks. In the time it took for me to get to this commercial read, they are now 3-point favorites over the Connecticut Huskies, and I do believe Caitlin Clark and company get it done tonight. Sign up now and take advantage of a generous welcome bonus on MyBookie with your first deposit all the way up to $1,000. Put in $200 and get $300 ready to play instantly using promo code 1010XL. The best part about MyBookie, you can bet on anything, anytime, from anywhere. Use promo code 1010XL to secure your welcome bonus today, only with MyBookie.
Race into Gate for big offers. By big, we mean great deals on Red Bull and a chance to win tickets to the big race coming to Miami May 3rd through 5th. Buy 2 8.4-ounce cans of Red Bull, get one free. And if you're a MyGate Rewards member, you are automatically entered for a chance to win race tickets. Not a member? Download the Gate app and sign up today. See store for details. Go from good to gate.
Welcome to Guggen Nation, 1010 XL, 92.5 FM.
At the First Coast YMCA, you'll find much more than just a gym. We offer many ways to help you be active, reach weight loss goals, and find your inner strength while you connect with your community. Family memberships at the Y include unlimited group exercise classes, childcare while you work out, and youth sports participation. It's easy to join the Y and affordable for all. Plus, the Y is a great place to meet a new circle of friends. Visit the Y near you or online at fcymca.org.
I'm with Greg from Cycles of Jacksonville, and when the sun's out, it's time to ride. And Triumph, tell me this, Greg, they've got new pricing that's going to bring more people to the showroom to check them out.
They do. They've got two hot new models, both under $6,000, one under $5,000. Same great, legendary Triumph quality and ride. You got to come see it.
And it's a big, heavy motorcycle underneath you.
It is. It's all Triumph.
Log on, cyclesofjacksonville.com, or check them out in the showroom. They're on Atlantic near Regency.
Mark Watson with Hardball Creative. When getting pens with your company's logo on them, get nice pens. No one wants to steal a pen that doesn't work. Check them out at hardballcreative.com.
Hardball Creative. Hardball does it all.
When it's time for the March Mania brackets to bust wide open. As I was saying, it's mad. The Mania of March at BetUS.com is all about those buzzer beat bonus offers. And when the madness starts and Cinderella man steps onto the BetUS always has your back with back-to-back-to-back 125% sign-up bonuses on your first three deposits and even 10% gambler's insurance. BetUS.com Sportsbook and Casino, where the game... Join today. BetUS Sportsbook and Casino, where the game begins.
Did you know Prime Roofing manufactures, fabricates, and installs their metal roofs? If you're thinking about a metal roof, think Prime Roofing. Schedule an estimate today at PrimeRoofingFL.com. That's PrimeRoofingFL.com.
Gator fans, get ready. The Orange and Blue game is back on Saturday, April 13th at 1 p.m. in the Swamp, and entry is free. This year, Florida Victorious is proud to sponsor the game, and we have tons of new excitement in store for you, like our player meet and greet and autograph session after the game on Steve Spurrier Field. As a member of Florida Victorious, you can visit with players on the team, including Mertz and Lagway. Don't miss out on FanFest, which begins at 10 a.m. on the North Lawn. Visit the Florida Victorious tent to learn more about the team and membership benefits, and also meet Gator student athletes. Join us for the chance to win a brand new Chevy Silverado on the field. Brought to you by Southern Chevy Dealers and Florida Victorious. Learn more about Florida Victorious and become a member at FloridaVictorious.com. FloridaVictorious.com. And help us make Florida victorious.
What city has hosted the most Super Bowls? The answer coming up.
Southern Oak Insurance knows that you want to save money on your homeowner's insurance. So why not try some old-fashioned common sense? Ask your Southern Oak agent about our roof replacement schedule. It will save you money.
Our family protecting yours. Southern Oak Insurance.
Miami has hosted the Super Bowl 11 times. New Orleans has had 10.
Southern Oak Insurance. Our family protecting yours.
At Dr. Reuter, we understand plumbing issues can be a real inconvenience for your building or business, and we're here to help. We can handle all kinds of plumbing jobs, including broken pipes, clogged drains, line jetting, installing water heaters, and full repipes. Need a camera inspection or a smoke test? Yes, Dr. Reuter does that too. Plus, our lift station services include inspections, monitoring, cleaning, and repairs. When you're stuck, call the Duck. 904-862-6769. That's 904-862-6769.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
On this lovely Friday, as we are dubbing it Feel Good Fridays. That is happening every Friday here on the program. We have some more Feel Good Fridays to share before we get to our next guest in just a moment.
Yes, I would be remiss if I didn't read this texter who not only texted in but sent us photos. Thank you, 264. My parents' dog, shout out to Honey and Red, just had puppies 3 weeks ago. I paid them a visit last night, and they are just oh so soothing. Oh, this is the melatonin. Not the
Love
melatonin.
It.
What's the serotonin? Serotonin, not melatonin.
We're going to sleep now.
Right, exactly. I don't need to go to sleep. St. Og Dog on the text line is already judging me because I said 9:30 for an Iowa tip was a little bit too late for my liking.
Oh, no. It is a Friday, I will say.
Yes.
But yeah, let's get it to our next guest, and we have a special movie clip to play for her.
Okay, girls, this is it. Harvey Field. Tryout. Get out there, show them what you got. Don't embarrass me.
All right, as we welcome in Bonnie Jill Laughlin, the first and only female NBA scout. That clip, of course, comes from A League of Their Own, and we're playing that because she wrote a book called In a League of Her Own, celebrating female firsts in sports. Bonnie Jill, thank you so much for joining us.
Absolutely. I talked to y'all before, and it was a fun time, so happy to be back.
Wonderful. Well, I can't wait. I already started the book, and I can't wait to finish it. I love...
Oh, thank you.
Of course, absolutely. I love the fact that we are celebrating women in sports every day nowadays, it feels like, especially with the women's basketball gaining so much popularity and gymnastics and swimming, you know, all the different sports. But I want to start with Billie Jean King. How much fun was it to interview her?
Oh, it was, you know, a dream, because when I first... went on this journey to write this book, I was like, if I don't have Billie Jean King, I don't have a book. So I'm like, when I put out my, you know, wish list and I was able to get her and do the interview with her via Zoom, it was just, you know, it's like a fangirl, you know, being able to speak to the legend. Yes. Is just amazing. And how grounded she was and how appreciative she was. She gets saying she was happy to be involved in this book. It's like, well, you are the first female. So you know what I mean? Like she's what you think of right away. So it was amazing to speak with her, also Danica Patrick and Layla Ali and Jackie Joyner Kersee and Mary Lou Retton and you name it. There was just so many women that I spoke to that just had fascinating stories, so many parallels that we had in our sacrifices to be in this industry. And it was pretty amazing to be able to just see how we related on so many levels.
Bonnie Jill, tell us maybe one of the favorite parts of one of the stories that you've been able to share, because obviously there's, you just mentioned a few of the names, but there's 19 stories in this book that you wrote of just fantastic women doing all sorts of things. What was one of your favorite that you kind of learned about?
There were so many that were, you know, so compelling to speak about, but I think one that seemed more shocking to me was when I spoke with Danica Patrick. As we know, she's very stoic, you know, kind of on and off the track. And when I spoke with her in the beginning, she wasn't really giving me much. She was just very, like, short answers. I'm like, oh, great. How am I going to turn this into a chapter? Well, started to speak to her. I started speaking about her dad and when her dad built her first go-kart and her having, you know, little girls go up and, you know, say that she was their role model and her and all these different things that came about, and she started crying. And we know Danica Patrick, you know, it's like, wow, she was actually crying, not mad crying because she's yelling at Tony Stewart, but like crying because she's actually, she said, I felt so moved. She said, because I didn't realize at the time I was a role model. I was just out there doing my thing. And now I look back at what an impact I made. And she's like, I wonder sometimes that I make the right decisions. And it was just a really great moment because she was so real and authentic. And I think that was the one that I really felt was a little different because I got something out of her that I know normally she doesn't speak about.
Bonnie Jill Laughlin is our guest. She is the first and only female NBA scout. You can purchase her new book, which was published in February, In a League of Her Own, on Amazon right now. Bonnie, we've gotten the chance to speak with you before, but our audience, since we've moved now to the 12-2 slot, may not be as familiar with your story. Walk us through how you did become the first and only female NBA scout.
Yeah, my journey was, you know, a little different. It was non-conventional becoming a scout. I started off working in sports as a cheerleader. I was a cheerleader for the Golden State Warriors, the San Francisco 49ers, and then the Dallas Cowboys while I was getting my degree in broadcast journalism at University of Texas. The broadcaster working for NFL Network and CBS, and I actually was a pre- and post-game host for the Lakers show, and I was always talking about talent and always talking about the triangle offense and Phil Jackson, and our GM, Mitch Kupchak, at the time was like, hey, you really have an eye for talent. Have you ever thought about scouting? And But now I just, you know, I like to talk about, you know, different matchups and, you know, watch the guys in college and all that good stuff. And he said, why don't you try it out? So I tried it out for a year, wasn't paid at all, proved myself, and they love my scouting reports, and ended up signing a five-year deal, another five-year deal, and it being the assistant GM for their G League team, and kind of the rest is history.
That's incredible. As far as your journey, we kind of talked about this on Monday as far as being, you know, one of the first all-female sports talk shows. What do you hope to, or what generation do you hope to inspire? Like, what do you hope that the next generation learns from all this?
It was definitely my why was to write a book that encompassed all the females that have done so many things, and not just as athletes, but in the front office or as a coach or as a ref or as an owner, and showing the younger females that through, you know, hard work, dedication, sacrifices, that you really can do anything you put your mind to. There may not even be a woman in that role, in that position, but you can create that and be that. And so that was my biggest thing, is that there's a space for you in sports. And as we're seeing with the Caitlin Clark and the movement, and I'm more into the women's March Madness than the men. I mean, I'll be honest. It's like, I've got my bracket for the men's, but I'm so zoned in and dialed in on this women's basketball all season long. So it's just showing that these women can be highlighted and mainstream, and you're going to see it during the Olympics with Katie Ledecky, and there's just so many empowering and inspiring women's stories, and it's starting to really translate across the country and worldwide.
Let's talk about that a little bit, the women's Final Four tonight, and the big one, we know, the UConn-Iowa, that's a lot of people will talk about. We'll address that, but I do want to get your thoughts on NC State and South Carolina. What is there a chance that NC State can upset? What are your thoughts on that matchup?
Well, if you look at the men, they've done it quite well, right? You know, they're the 11th seed in the men's conference. So it's funny how, you know, you never know. It's just like with basketball and, you know, any kind of with football, I say any given Sunday. And the same thing with basketball. You just, you know, you never know how the matchup's going to be. I do see, I mean, I kind of would love to see an upset. So I wouldn't be shocked if NC State gets in there and gets a W. Now, with the Iowa and UConn, we all know that, you know, with Caitlin Clark, and she's playing so well on the road as well, I think it was kind of good for her to get away from Iowa. She's not turning over the ball as much, but I think that it's just so hard to beat her. I mean, defensively and the way she moves and passes the ball and shooting for deep, it's just, it's crazy. It's, how do you even defend her? So I really hope, I've, you know, definitely jumped on that Caitlin Clark bandwagon. And so I really would love to see her win it all. I would have loved to see LSU in Iowa in the championship instead. Whoever did the bracket really messed up, but yeah, that would have been great.
ESPN did the bracket, Bonnie Jill. I'm not going to call out the mouse like that, but I am. They knew what was coming on past Monday if they put it in the Elite Eight as opposed to the national title game.
Right.
I do want to get your picks for the men's side before we let you go, which thanks so much for joining us in the All-Pro Roofing Hotline. But speaking of Caitlin, and as a scout yourself, there's been so much conversation surrounding how she will translate to the next level, if teams will be able to figure her out. I have heard on the other side of the argument, teams in the WNBA, players are not used to picking someone up that far out, akin to when Steph Curry entered the NBA. I'm curious your take on how she'll translate.
You know, it's funny because you wonder, you know, because a lot of it's going to be how she translates into the game being so much quicker, right? And so much more physicality. So she's so above right now the college level that I think she will translate well. Plus, she's got that kind of that Kobe Mamba type of personality where even if she's not doing as well and putting up 41 points, that she's going to be able to get back in there and not get discouraged and not get down. And I really think a lot of that's that mindset that I think she'll do so well at. And of course, the game is faster, but I think if anyone can do it, it's going to be her. So I definitely think that she's going to have no problem. And then you look at, you know, what's going on, I think, was it Ice Cube? I think didn't he offer her like $5 million to play in the big three? So for him to even say that she, you know, she could play against the guys, it's telling you something.
Certainly. All right. Who you got on the men's side?
Oh, gosh. It's so tough. Oh, I had Houston.
I did too. Yes.
Yeah, I had Houston. So now it's like once your bracket is broken, you kind of just, you know, I don't know. I don't care as much, but I actually, again, I hate to mention NC State again, but I would love for the first time ever to see an 11 seed,
yes,
you know, win it all. I'm kind of like the underdog. You know, I like that dark horse. So that's who I'm rooting for.
I like it. All right. Tell us about Hounds and Heroes and Horses. I think this is such an amazing venture.
It is something I started in 2010. I wanted to combine my passions, which is military and also animal welfare. So we rescue dogs from the shelter that would otherwise be euthanized, and then we pair them up with wounded warriors that are coming back from, you know, combat situations, deployments, whether it's PTSD, TBI, or amputees, and we pair them up as service and therapy dogs. And then we do the same thing with horses, with equine therapy retreats, having the wounded warriors come out to my ranch in Fort Worth, Texas, and also disabled children and children of fallen soldiers and first responders as well.
That is absolutely amazing. Houndsandheroes.com if people want to learn more and donate, right, Bonnie Jill?
Absolutely, and thank you so much for mentioning that.
For sure. We appreciate you so much for joining us. And again, people can find your book, In a League of Her Own, Celebrating Female First in Sports, on Amazon. Thank you, Bonnie Jill.
Thanks, y'all. Have a good weekend.
You too. Thanks, you too. So I would have loved to ask her all about Texas football. Mm-hmm. That wasn't what this conversation was about, but yeah. Have you met Matthew McConaughey?
Yeah, yeah.
What do you think about Quinn Ewers versus Arch Manning?
She had a relationship with Kobe Bryant, and that's always something, too, that's so interesting. I've seen a lot of her comments on that, and Kobe was kind of a part of her career that gave her advice early on that was like, don't listen to these people, like, keep doing you. There's, you know, pretty much there's going to be haters, and keep going. And so imagine Kobe Bryant saying that and that being in your head for the rest of your life.
Yeah, that is such good advice. All right, thanks again to Bonnie Jill Laughlin. And again, that book, In a League of Her Own, Celebrating Female First in Sports. We have 1 second to go here on Helmets and Heels on a feel-good Friday on 1010XL on 82.5 FM.
Connect with 1010XL.
On the line.
Online.
With your friends. Now everyone's exchanging ideas.
Find 1010XL on your social channels.
Let's fire up the flavor and ignite those appetites. Let's slow down and smell the barbecue. Because all your favorites are smoked for hours and ready for eating when you are. From our famous ribs to slow smoked pork. Enjoy some perfection by the plateful, safely in our dining room or in the comfort of your home. With curbside pickup, drive-through, and delivery. Sonny's Barbecue, local pitmasters since 68.
If you are having problems related to selling your home, here's your solution. You just have not discovered ChadAndSandy.com. That's ChadAndSandy.com. Listen, maybe the problem is you need more space for your office or growing family, or perhaps you're worried about settling for less money with a lowball instant offer. We've got one guarantee here that always rings true. Chad and Sandy guarantee your home sold at an agreed-upon price and deadline, or they will buy it. It's as simple as that. So you need to call 904-414-6200 or go to chadandsandy.com like Jonathan in Mount Pleasant did. The only thing standing between me and my dream of traveling in my RV was the sale of my Mount Pleasant home. I heard Chad and Sandy on the radio and called. Crazy results. In just 3 days, I received multiple offers for full asking price. So you don't have the problems you think you do. You have solutions and promises with Chad and Sandy. Go to chadandsandy.com or call 904-414-6200. 6200 at chadandsandy.com.
Tired of dealing with clogged drains? What about those bad smells coming from your pipes? No matter how big or small your commercial or residential project may be, my friends at Duck Duck Rooter can handle it. Contact them today for all your plumbing, septic, and air conditioning needs at 904-862-6769. And while I have your attention, Duck Duck Rooter is also hiring plumbers. They offer excellent weekly pay, health insurance, paid holidays, 401k, and more. Apply now at duckduckrooter.com, and they will call you for an interview.
Are you 18 years or older, just got married, just got divorced, or have children? Listen up. Have you done your last will and estate planning? If you have questions, call Matt Hinson with the Hinson Law Firm. Reach him at 527-1700, office is Jacksonville, Florida. And don't let the state decide your fate.
Now your ideas don't have to wait. Now they have everything they need to come to life. Dell Technologies and Intel are creating technology that loves ideas, loves expanding your business, evolving your passions. We push what technology can do, so great ideas can happen right now. Find out how to bring your ideas to life at Dell.com. Welcome to now.
Folks, the First Coast has voted. Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute is proud to be chosen as Bold City's best in four categories: best orthopedic practice, physical therapy, pain management, and foot care clinic. For the last 30 years, JOI has continually strived for the highest level of orthopedic surgery and rehab care. As the needs of the community evolve, so will they. That's why coaches, parents, and athletes choose JOI. Call them at JOI 2000 or visit joi.net. JOI, where the pros go.
American Electrical, Northeast Florida's highest rated electricians, is hiring, and they're looking for people to train for careers. It's not just job training. They're giving you a license that no one can take away from you, training you for jobs that are always in demand and will offer you a peace of mind financially and for the future. Once you know a trade, you'll always be employable. All the details are at American-Electrical.com, and with their American Electrical Academy, if you're selected, you'll learn the electrical trade absolutely free of charge. American Electrical Contractors, powered by professionalism.
ET here, and it's time for the Taste of Golf at TPC Sawgrass, April 24th. Join me for fine cuisine from chefs from the top golf clubs in our area, craft cocktails, games, and unique auction items. This is one of the most charitable events in our area. Come network with a sophisticated audience who is passionate about golf and its values, all while impacting the youth in our community. All proceeds benefit First Tee North Florida. For tickets, go to tasteofgolf.com. Come on, somebody.
Hacker here. You know, there was a time when negative comments on social media about my weight just faded into the background. I got so used to seeing them. However, in just 5 weeks, everything has taken a 180. I now notice comments about my weight again because they're completely different. Thanks to dropping a whopping 40 pounds already with Awaken 180. People are noticing and rooting me on. It feels absolutely incredible. I'm diving back into clothes I haven't worn in 15 years, turning back time while losing 5 pounds a week, thanks to Awaken 180 Weight Loss. I have a whole new outlook on life. I've been down other weight loss roads before, but nothing compares to this. The shift from not noticing the negative to embracing the positive has been profound. So what are you waiting for? Join me on this transformation with Awaken 180. Call 844-346-1800. That's 844-346-1800. 1800 or online at awaken180weightloss.com.
This is Joe C. from XL Primetime, and stoked to crank up the 9 after 5 once again at the Golf Club of Southampton. Every Wednesday, a little after 5, the gang at Southampton will be hosting us with a new game, and I'm inviting you to be a part of it. Now through the summer stretch, break up the week with a little hump day fun every Wednesday. Call 287-PLAY to get on the tee sheet. There'll be food afterwards and prizes, including playing for a membership at the Golf Club of Southampton. Call 287-PLAY and hit the tee with Joe C.
Dan Hicken and Jack Prosser share the huddle with Freddie T.
Bring it in!
Monday morning running back with Fred Taylor is fueled by Epstein and Robbins.
Fred Taylor, he's a candidate to go the distance.
And B&B Fuel and Lubricants on 1010XL.
Everyone seems to be in a time crunch these days. Well, don't forget, you can always count on the cold case at Daly's. Always convenient, always cold. Whether it's the King of Beers, Natty Light, Stella, or Cigar City, the Goose Island, or Bud Light Seltzer. Dash into Daly's and grab one to go.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
There's something in water around here. It's more than just boats and beers. It's new friends, old songs, sunsets, sing-alongs, and problems that disappear. And
this, it don't matter. This will be your new favorite summer song. I'm declaring it now. Zach Brown Band, the song is called Tie Up. I have to talk over it because we only have one segment to go, otherwise I'd let the whole song play. But if you've ever been to Fort George, or if you want to go south and go to St. Augustine and go to the Tidal Islands down there, this song has to be played when you're on a boat this summer. I'm just telling you now, the song came out 2 weeks ago. And
I was going to say, I hadn't heard it yet. It's very good.
I am the person who is constantly in search of brand new music. And so every single time on Fridays when the new music drops, I will create a new playlist with the brand new music. And like I said, this song, I'm just telling you, if you like country, of course. This will be your summer song. It's so good. By the way, local sports right now, FSU baseball taking on Boston College. It is 0-0 at the bottom of the third. So FSU up in Boston, no score in that game.
I would think the weather is a bit more frightful up there than Jacksonville.
I saw FSU baseball tweeted out earlier today.
The sun came
75.
out.
Yeah, the sun came out in Chicago, too, for the first time in like 2 weeks. So
but it says,
it's still cold.
But I just looked, and it says 42 degrees. So yeah. FSU baseball's tweet of sunny and 75
75. I think they were
trying to put themselves
to manifest that weather, but clearly that did not happen. In Florida's case, they are at Missouri for a weekend series starting tonight, 7 p.m., as the Gators look to win yet another SEC series. JU and UNF both home this weekend, so if you want to get out and see some baseball, JU plays host to North Alabama. That starts tonight at 7 o'clock, and then UNF plays host to Eastern Kentucky. That also starts tonight, but that one first pitch, 6 o'clock. If you've never been to a JU or a UNF baseball game, you are totally missing out. Obviously, I worked at UNF for a year, and so I had a lot of control over the music played at baseball. They had a lot of country back then. I'm sure they still do. It's baseball. Yeah. And then JU's baseball stadium is right overlooking the water, the river. And so it is absolutely beautiful. So make sure you get on out and catch some local sports this weekend. All right, Taylor, we've got some more Feel Good Friday stories.
Yes, we have few Feel Good Fridays. We have a few new ideas for our listener names. And we have some one-word responses for Trevor. Let's start with the Feel Good Fridays. We have someone said Spring in the Blues is this weekend, which
Spring
that's
in
out
the Blues
the
is this weekend.
That's out at the beach.
Seawalk Pavilion. It is all free.
Fantastic. So he said, obviously, live music, sunshine. The weather looks perfect this weekend.
Yep,
so that's
tonight.
What's making him feel good on this Friday. Someone else said it's a perfect motorcycle riding day.
Okay.
I could understand that. I'm not a motorcycle rider, but I feel like this would be the perfect weather.
Good bicycle riding for us bicyclists.
Yes. For us beach cruisers.
I feel that as well for the motorcycle gang.
And then we had another one where someone just sent the whole trap of his crabs he just caught. And it made me very hungry, honestly.
Love crab
because
traps.
I love crab. It's one of my favorite foods probably in general. So some fun things. There's also, we mentioned in the beginning of the week, Brunch Fest is out in Riverside area this weekend too, on Sunday, I believe. So there's a lot of outdoor activities going on this weekend and the perfect weekend to be outside. But a few of the names, potential names for our listeners. We have the 911 said, not the police, but they said,
but we know they're listening too.
They said over the heel gang.
Okay. I don't love that. That's kind of a jab at age. I don't know about that one.
The 110 said the heelaholics.
I like that one.
905 said healers. And he said, this is in regards to the cute dogs.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
494 said the heel raisers. That one's
fun. I like that one.
600 said sexual healing.
Okay, we're not going to go with that one, but it's funny.
The 600, that was that one. And then the 095 said the Duval Divas.
Ooh.
So we've got some
are
good
we divas,
ones
though?
In
RJ, are we divas? I don't know about that.
Nah.
Yeah. We're not divas.
My working theory is working idea is that we're going to say heelies or heeligans, one or the other, but then for those that maybe were like, where are you coming from with that? Those are the heel billies.
Or the heel raisers.
Yeah. Or the heel raisers.
I do like heel billies and heel raisers.
Funny.
We might have to on Monday put this out on a Twitter poll.
Yeah.
Narrow it down to four, put it on a Twitter poll and see what the people decide. By the way, Ryan Day on Twitter says, Trevor's the only reason he gets out of bed in the morning, and if he ever wins a Super Bowl with another team, he's going to, and then did not finish his sentence.
And that's Ryan Day, the editor emeritus of Big Cat Country, not Ryan Day, the Ohio State football coach.
Yes, exactly.
Although he probably has an opinion about Trevor, perhaps, too.
Yeah, a few more words about Trevor, if you had to use just one word. Tough says fighter, which I certainly can understand that. And then we had several responses that were not just one word. Someone else said goat. I don't know if we can say that yet. And then we had another one that said mid, which y'all taught me means just average.
Yeah,
so, all right, that's the end of our week, ladies, our first week. Thank you so much, RJ Saunders, for being the best producer.
Open gym Sunday, 11 a.m.
That's right here on the Superstation. For Taylor Dahl, for Mia O'Brien, I'm Lauren Brooks. These heels are made for talking. We will talk to you on Monday.
Yeah. Mia here for Window Gang. It's spring and time to give your home or business a refresh. Window Gang's exterior.